So, this will come here. Don't delay.
Okay.
You can do such a thing.
Thank you.
Sannyasi Deva. Author gives a not jump, others you should have the honor for superiors. No? We should learn to give respect to senior devotees of Swamiji. So you should go there and here. Understand me?
You should give some respect to those who are senior. Best is if you sit somewhere.
There. You have any question?
Any question to you?
No, you should go and give. Oh, there are so many seniors. Like they are, I honor them. But they are so humble that they are sitting there. You should be humble so much. And give so much honor to seniors. Then you can go on. You should learn. All should learn. At the time of taking prasadam, at the time of also kirtan, at the time of sitting anywhere, we should try to always give honor to all. In the morning, when we are doing parikrama, senior should go forward and junior gradually, not to disturb anyone. Not to disturb. Always keeping honor. If you are not giving honor and you are not humble, you cannot progress. Juniors should also give honor, and seniors, they will teach them with, like son, like younger brother, with love and affection. But they should be taught all these rules and regulations. Always try to respect seniors, always. But seniors should see also that if anyone, being shishya of shishya, but he has so much, what? No. If he is qualified, he has given all his worldly things, and he knows all the transcendental truths, practicing bhakti yoga, and he is serving so much Vaishnava and Guru, then he should also respect him, always, not gratitude. In this way, we can increase our things. You know, Swamiji preached everywhere in world. See, Pujya Bhaskar Maharaj was sitting in Navadvip. And how he used to give him honor, you know? Now disciples perhaps not knowing, because they are concealing these facts. He has so much honor for my Gurudev. So much. So his seniors, always, like Siksha Guru, like I honor my God brothers, like my Siksha Guru, to become Maharaj, Brahman Maharaj, to others, they are very senior. They respect so much, but I always give him. So, Pujyapas, Swami Maharaj was in the line of Vaishnava, Guru. So he must respect, he used to give respect to Pujyapas Sridhar Maharaj, Bhakti Vilastit Maharaj and all others. So we should know all the etiquettes. This is Vaishnava etiquette.
Jnana Nirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitangina Tasmai Shri Gurave Vancha Kalpatarubhyasya Kripa Sindhubhyaivacha Patitanam Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitandanam Negaurasya गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय यं प्राप्रजं तमनुपेतमपेत कृत्यं दैपायनो विरह कातरया जिभाव पुत्रेति तन्मेतया तर्वो विनेदि तं सर्वभूत हृदयं मुनिमातुष तवैवास्मि न जीवान् त्वया विना इति विज्ञैराद्वैतं मेन। You know, Sanatana Goswami, also you have perhaps heard the name of Jagadananda Prabhu. Jagadananda Prabhu, from boyhood of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was in Navadvip Leela also. And he was like Satyabhama, having some maan. Sanatana Goswami was the prime minister of any Muslim king, and he was so intelligent, learner of all shastra. In Puri once he came, and then he met with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and then he returned to Vrindavan. Jagadananda was there. He wanted to serve Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Oh, he wanted to serve so much. Sometimes he brought, anyone brought a vessel, full pot of very fragrant Ayurveda oil. Because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sometimes he used to faint in Krishna consciousness. So he brought with great care. He gave it to Govinda, that, oh, yes, put on the head of Mahaprabhu, oh, some oil tea. Then Govinda told to Mahaprabhu that Jagadananda has ordered me to put some oil on your eyes. This is Ayurvedic, very powerful, like medicine. Mahaprabhu told humbly, that take this oil to Jagannath temple and give it to for Deepak, for lamp. So he could not put the oil on the head of Mahaprabhu. Next day, Jagadananda asked to Govinda that, have you put this oil on his head? He told us, I could not. Why? Oh, he ordered me to give this oil to Jagannath. And by thus, oh, I will have that thing. He became very upset. And he took that oil pot, and in the front of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he smashed. And all water, oil, here and there. And he became so angry. And he went from there. He went to his bhajan koti and he locked the door. How are you, can you say? Locked. Anyhow. One day, 2 days, he was crying, but not coming to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu thinking that, oh, he has some anger to me because I am not accepted. And that is why he one day, third day, then he, on fourth day in morning he went and he knocked the door. Oh, Jagadananda, oh, Jagadananda. But he was not replying, only weeping. Mahaprabhu told that, for 3 days I have not taken anything. Empty stomach. And now I am so much hungry. I am going to take bath in ocean. And very soon I am coming. Be prepared all kinds of preparations for me. And telling he went away. And he went to sea and took bath. And he again returned after 1 hour. In the meantime, Jagadananda, he took bath, changed his clothes, and then began to prepare so many kinds of vegetables, rice, dal, chapati, and so many things. Chutney of tamarind leaves, so many things. About more than 56 more than. And he brought a very big banana leaf, 2-3, and he preparation. Gobind was with Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu told, he requested Gobind that tell Mahaprabhu to take prasadam. Mahaprabhu told that I cannot take. Oh, there should be 2 seeds and 2 leaves. And I will sit with Jagadananda. And we will take prasadam together. And if he is not taking, then I am going. Empty stomach. Then Jagadananda told to, not directly telling to Mahaprabhu.
Not directly talking.
He told to Govinda, tell Mahaprabhu that he should take gladly, and after that, when he will finish, then we will both take together remnant of Mahaprabhu. Then he told to Mahaprabhu, you should take, he will take after you. So only remnant he will take. Then Mahaprabhu took prasadam. And then after that, that remnant was divided into 2 and eternal. Then he became happy, but he was not coming directly to speak Mahaprabhu anything. Even there was some smell of man. He went again after 2-3 days to Mahaprabhu and told that, I am going to Vrindavan. Please order me. I want your permission. Mahaprabhu said, why you are going? For so many long time I wanted to go with you, but you could not take me with you. So now I want to go and to take darshan. I want to be there and to serve Radha Krishna Kanduga. Mahaprabhu told, you can go, but not for
long time.
Go and see and return back. Don't climb on the
top of Govardhan.
You are not qualified to be there. You can quarrel there. You can see the rules and regulations. A Brajvasi is not taking bath or what he is doing. So then you will judge according to your mentality. So you make some offenses. So don't be there. You should return back. He went anyhow. But when he left Puri and he came to border under a tree, then he was lamenting so much. Why I did so mistake? I cannot be life without Mahaprabhu. I have done wrong. Should I go return? But how can I return? Then what will I answer? And he was in dilemma, what to do, not to do. One day, 2 days, he was there, weeping. Anyhow, he consoled his mind. Anyhow, I should go. Then he went to Vrindavan. And he met Sanatan Goswami. Sanatan Goswami told that you should be here and see with me all the pastime places. One day, Sanatan Goswami was out of his bhajan kuti and he was cooking. He never took any Madhukari. But I am not qualified for Madhukari. Sanatana Goswami, Rupa Goswami, they are qualified. I cannot digest. We cannot digest Madhukari. We are not qualified. So he was there and cooking. And what became? Sanatana Goswami took any saffron cloth from anyone. And he did like this. And he returned. Then he was cooking, and the pot was on fire.
Stove.
It was so hot. It was khichdi. It was doing takbak. Takbak, you know? Why? So Sanatana Goswami, he asked Sanatana Goswami, you are very faithful to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From where is this collected this cloth of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? He told simply that it is not of Mahaprabhu, it is of any Mayavadi here. And he gave me and I took. Oh, of Mayavadi? He at once took that pot and he... Then Chaitanya, Sanatana Goswami became very humble, and he was just smiling and telling, I was testing you. I know that you have so much faith on Mahaprabhu. So much faith. Huh? And you cannot bear any others, the saffron cloth of Mayavadi. Huh? You are so attached to Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu rebukes you. What is it meaning? He loves you so much. So he gives you madhurya ras of rebuking. And to me, Sanatana Goswami told, Sanatana Goswami is so honorable person. He is so high class of devotee. He is superior to all. So this is like nimbaras. Nimbaras, the juice of mint. When Sanatana Goswami was in Puri, and Sanatana Goswami was feeling himself that I'm so low, I'm so wretched person. He has some itches coming in the way, some mosquitoes has gotten, so much juice from his body was coming. Pus, very bad smelling. And Mahaprabhu, what he used to do? To embrace him. And Sanatana Goswami, you will say, don't touch Prabhu. But then Sanatana Goswami met with Jagadananda and told, what should I do? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu always wants to embrace me, and I'm so wretched, and this is and what coming? First coming, and Mahaprabhu touches me. What should I do? Should I return to Vrindavan? Yes, you should go to Vrindavan. Don't be here. Otherwise Mahaprabhu will touch you and he may have some disease, so you should quickly go. Mahaprabhu heard this and told to Jagadan, Jagai, you are a boy of only 2 days. And you are being instructor of Sanatana Goswami. How he is superior, and you have dared to give some intelligence and advice. Don't think you like that you are so of 2 days only. Why only? Having no intelligence. He gave that. We should honor. Especially those who are pure devotees, they should be humble and try to give honor to others. This is only way to progress in Krishna consciousness. Now we should come to our point. Now it is 7. Come to with me in Vrindavan or Mathura. We concentrate your minds, no? You know that all the human beings in the whole world, even you are in America, the richest person now it is in the whole world. And you are making so much money, your house is full of all kinds of comforts and everything. Very, very beautiful wife you have. And when she becomes of 1 year, 2 years, you can divorce and again you pick up. And very good children qualify. Everything is okay. Having 2, 3, 4, 5 dogs, no harm. But even there are so many problems. All are suffering. Especially those who are rich, more suffering than anyone. So in this world, anyone is not happy. And this life is full of miseries, problems, difficulties, sorrow, suffering, and oldness also, and so many things. So rogues, full of rogues, diseases. In this world there is none who has never tested any kinds of suffering, sorrows or problems. I think among you there are so many rich persons. But any of you can raise hand that I have never had any problem without problem and I am always all time I am happy. Can anyone tell? Oh, today morning you are telling that I am sick. I remember. So, in this world, none. Whether he can be king, prime minister, president or anything. Only if there is any devotee surrendered to Krishna, he may be happy. But he will tell, I am not happy. He never will tell. What he will tell? Oh, very big problem. Why I am alive? Why I am not dying? Because I have no darshan of Krishna. So in this world, anyone is not happy. All the jivas, they want happiness. There are so many sufferings, problems in this world, and all are unhappy. That is why all want pure happiness. But it is absurd in this maya sansara, in this material world, anyone can have happiness. That is why all the Vedas has told, sukham me bhuyat, dukham me ma bhuta. All the Vedas are telling that we should always be happy. Always happiness comes to me. And suffering should not come. In Srimad Bhagavatam, it has been told, karmanya rahmananam dukkhattai sukhaya cha pashet pakam viparyasam mithuni charinam. In whole world, all are trying to have happiness. They want to be happy. For this, they try themselves or mixing with wife and husband, sometimes whole family, sometimes like Sanyukta Rashtra, Assembly of all the United Nations. They try, but they cannot check wars, they cannot check anything, because they are themselves having so many problems. If they have so many problems, how they can solve other problems? They cannot. So it is told that we are trying for happiness, but our sufferings are so strong. They come and they keep their fists on our head, and for sadly, what? We'll have to test for sadly. We are bound to test them. Can you have any remedy to escape from old age? Never. From death? Never. So all want that I should be happy. But only wanting will do. All want. But all are dukhi, all are suffering. But it cannot be told that always they are unhappy and they have no a piece of happiness. Oh, they have. But that happiness is like a very little. And at once they pass. Again, second, always problems coming, suffering coming, like waves. We say that, oh, this problem we will solve and we will be happy. In the meantime, you are saying, oh, more bigger problem coming. So we are bound to this. Something coming from when you are married, at once you are saying that, oh, at the day of marriage, oh, very beautiful, very beautiful. And next day we will see, she will want some ornaments and so many things. Or she will first control that you should not love anyone. If you have any girlfriend, you should. Oh, he cannot do it. And so many problems come. So, in this world, there is no pure happiness. But we, anyhow, we want pure happiness. And what is pure happiness? There is happiness, but not in this world. And that is called Brahmananda. What a jiva can test in himself, if he can attain salvation, then he can test Brahmananda, no distress at all. But Brahmananda is also not pure, not any affirmative, negative way. Like, what is negative? What negative? If a man has caught anyone and he was going to chop his. Then he was crying, shame me, shame me, shame me. And he was about to die. And he was pushing. But anyone came and saved him. And then he stood up and, now I'm saved. So this is salvation and this is Brahmananda life. Not positive anything. But if you are serving Krishna, really, that is happiness. Otherwise, not. Krishna is the embodiment of Ananda. I am Anandam, I am Brahma. If you are not following, serving, chanting, remembering Krishna, you cannot be happy in any way. So this is called not Brahma Ananda, this is called praying, love and affection to Krishna. And these are so many various of kinds. So he wants happiness, but he does not know what is happiness. Really, to serve Krishna, and the love and affection of gopis serving Krishna, and they are having so much ananda, ananda pure. So really we want like such love and affection, but we don't know what is that. But we want to happiness like such. Oh, if anyone wants to be happy, Krishna has transformed into Shastra. So in Shastra is written that if you will follow my instructions, you can have that kind of love and affection. So Shastra has told. And in all Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam is Amal Shastra, to whom you can rely and believe. He cannot cheat you, because Srimad Bhagavat is the embodiment of Krishna himself. For in all Shastra it has been written that if you will serve Krishna, then you will really be happy. If you are chanting, remembering Krishna, then by doing bhakti to Krishna, Bhagavan Krishna, Swayam Bhagavan Krishna will be happy, and then you must be happy. But Srimad Bhagavat was telling, he is telling some difference. What? Srimad Bhagavat is telling, all jivas, you have no power, no, you have no qualification that you can serve Krishna. Never you can. You are like powerless. You cannot serve. You cannot call Krishna. Never you can call. All Shastra has told that you should remember and call Krishna. Hare Nam, Hare Nam, Hare Nam. Kalau Naste, Naste, Naste. It has told in Vishnu Purana or other Purana, not in Srimad Bhagavatam. So all Shastra has told that you should do bhajan to Krishna. But Srimad Bhagavat, what is telling? Oh, you cannot call Krishna. Oh, Krishna is descending to call you. He is so merciful. Out of mercy, he has descended to this world. You cannot go there and serve. Can you go to Vrindavan, Gokul, Navadvip, Dham there, Shwetadvip? You cannot go. You cannot call him. But Krishna is so, the Krishna of Srimad Bhagavatam is so merciful. He took his float and he descended to this earth in Vrindavan, and he was calling to all. Come on, come on, come on. Oh, you should only hear from, you should give your ears. Only ear, not I don't want anything. Guru, the real Guru, qualified Guru, only tells, oh, give your ears to me. I don't want anything. Your wealth, your anything I don't want. I want your ears. And I want to purify your ears. And by ear, I will give something in your heart that you will be happy forever. Transcendental happiness will come to you. Other, there is no other process to be happy. You are crying for Krishna, but your crying has no power. How your crying? I am giving an example. Our crying is like this. Oh, there was a very beautiful class, very powerful class. All the devotees were there. And those who were speaking Srimad Bhagavatam, telling Harikatha, he had so much vigor. And also,
long hair.
And it was quietly, it has become white. And he was telling like this and that. And his dear walls. All were attentively hearing. And old ladies, he was sitting there. And always weeping. Tears coming. The Sadhu Baba who was speaking Harikatha, when it was finished the class, all went gracefully. And lady was there. He called that lady, "Oh mother, well, you are a very high class of people. My what Harikatha touched your heart. And why you are weeping so bitterly?" Then he again began to weep more and telling that, "Baba, what to tell? I have a what? Not bakari, bakari. Male goat. And he was so strong. And he has so much beard like you. Just sometimes I used to give something to eat and then he happily used to eat like this." So when you are telling Baba Harikatha, your yes, like my, I remember always my that goat, and anyone has just stolen away, what to do? I am weeping for that. Our calling to Krishna is like that. So, it may be some lens, but not some lens, pratibimba.
Reflection.
Our arti should be pure. Oh, we cannot have that kind of arti. Arti means?
Sincere prayer.
With separation mode. From heart, core of heart. But Krishna has this thing. And that is why he descended. Oh, lakhs and lakhs, koti. More than us. He is weeping for us. Because he is father of father, beloved of beloved. He has so much love and affection for us. Oh, they are suffering so much for getting me. They cannot come to me. They cannot even call me, weeping bitterly, not heart-mended. So I must go to them. And that is why he descended. With his flow, his all beauty, essence of all the beauty he took. And he can. And he is calling us. But we are not here. Try to realize this. Sarva bhuta manoharam ajak jagam kalau
bam
disha manoharam. Oh, he took his flute. And he was singing on cling. And he was calling. But we cannot hear this sound also. We are not so much qualified. So we cannot go to Krishna and call. That is why Krishna came. Even in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, conjugal, both they came. Only to call us. And he went here and there and he took sannyas, Chaitanya. So Bhagavat is telling like this. Nigama kalpataror kalitanga palam sukham khad amrit dravasanam gudam. Vivata bhagavatam rasamalayam muhuroho rasika. Krishna became like fruit. Nigama kalpataror fruit. No? Nothing. Only rasa. And he was brought by whom? Sukhdev Goswami in Guru Parampara. So, Krishna has descended to this world to call us. Why? Oh, don't be suffering. Be happy. Transcendental happiness you should have and to give. But, we are not qualified. Even to this, we don't want to be transcendental happy. Oh, Bhagavata is telling, Kanga Dayalum Sharanam Brajanta. He is asking to all others, Ved, Upanishad, Puran, Mahabharata, Ramayana, to all, Srimad Bhagavati questioning, Kanga Dayalum Sharanam Brajema. He is asking, but none is replying. And then Srimad Bhagavata himself, Oh Bakiyam Stanakal. Even a demon-like putana, always taking the flesh and new bloods of babies everywhere. So this demon, and went to kill Krishna. And what Krishna did? He changed his cloth, he changed his body, and he sent to Vaikuntha, more than that. So, we should try to serve Krishna and to hear Krishna. We should be qualified. How you can? Or throw any qualified devotee. Like guru, devotee, same thing. Without you cannot go. So all, Shastra told that all human want happiness and they want to meet with Krishna, but Bhagavad tells what? Bhagavan wants jeev. You know also that in all Shastra it has been told that when Krishna went to Mathura and Gopi was feeling separation, then all Shastra are telling what? That gopis sent any hansa, swan, where? To Mathura, to tell their separation news, how they are suffering. But Srimad Bhagavata is telling another thing, what? Krishna was suffering so much. And he was suffering so much that he had to send his messenger. Understanding? Gopis are not sending, but Krishna is sending because he is so merciful. So merciful. So bhakti is so much katar for Bhagavan. Katar means? Always suffering, always weeping, separation, feeling separation. Hankering. But Srimad Bhagavata was telling opposite. Krishna is hankering from his devotees. Always. Krishna always calling. But, oh mother, mother. And he is searching where my boyfriend are here. All Gwalbal. Brahma has taken them. And he is searching them. So Krishna is searching us. But we are so unqualified that we cannot hear his flow. We cannot call with our voice. So we should try. But you can only try when your heart is so empty and you have taken the shelter of any high class of devotees. Then Krishna has come and has gone to Mathura. Now in the beginning I told 5 or 6 questions. No? What questions? Braja, Vrindavan, Gokul, Mathura, Gokul and all other. Braja, Bhumi, is the place of so high class of love and affection. No? Vrindavan is himself, itself, rasa. So why Krishna left Vrindavan and went to Mathura and to Dwarka? Why?
Duty, Maharaj!
Why?
He saw it as a duty, Maharaj.
So there is a question. That why Krishna He is Vasana for himself, and Vrindavan is also Vasana for us. And even he left it. Secondly, if he went, if there was any cause, we go anywhere for any special reason, cause, and if cause is finished, we return. So if Krishna has left Vrindavan for any special reason, a special cause, that cause should be finished and he should return to Vrindavan. But he never returned. Oh. What is the answer of this? Anyone wants to leave the place where he receives so much love and affection. He doesn't want to taste any lower kind of
love and affection.
Like if you are having rasagolla, then if anyone giving you some good in India or anything, you cannot take it. You want to set rasagolla first. So, why Krishna, lover like gopis, Mother Jashoda, Nanda Baba and others, and quickly he left in a day and he never returned. Why? Third question. Oh, he is not coming forever, but he can come time to time. What harm? If anyone has gone, come to America from India to make some money, and if money is sufficient, and then he can return. If in case he is not returning, but he can go to India to meet his relatives, he may go. So Krishna, why not going to meet their relatives, his father and mother? He should go, but he is not going at all. Oh, today he is sending a messenger, but why not himself going? He is sending messenger. Messenger cannot do the same thing what Krishna can do. He knows that they will be not satisfied. They will only be satisfied if I am going there. But he is sending messenger and giving what? A letter to them that you should give this sandesh, this message to them. Oh, if there is so much heavy reason, cause, heavy means important cause or reason, that he cannot return to them. Then there is some way that he can call all the Brajavasi to Mathura or Dwarka. There is no lacking of any space, so much space. He can do anything. He can supply all houses and boarding and everything, as he gave, hosted all Mathura Vasi. So he can bring all, and he will be in Mathura, in Dwarka, he should be in Mathura, and with all Brajavasi. Why he is not bringing them? Oh, if you want to know all the answers of all the questions, then you will have to go deep in Srimad Bhagavatam with any high class of devotees who has served his Gurudev, the devotees, and he has served Bhagavatam with Bhagavatam. What is meaning? He should serve Bhagavatam. With because the key and lock is in the hands of Mahabhagavata. Then we don't want to serve any Mahabhagavatam. We don't want to give honor to all, but we want that our all answers should be satisfied. Huh? How it can be? So Krishna is so merciful. He is sending his any kinds of devotees. Oh, go and tell some answers, so that they may be advocated like this. Now you are coming to our questions, that answer, that it is to first questions and answer. Why he left? I told one reason of Prem Sarovar. Krishna is so worried that gopis went with me. They felt so much preparation for future, and they became like lifeless in Prem Vaichitya, in Mahabhav, in what? Prem Vaichitya Arita? Dibyonmad. You cannot imagine all these things. And feeling so much separation, burning in fire of separation. So Krishna wanted that. If I am out of Vrindavan, they will feel in separation, and in separation mode they will meet me. In dream, even in any way. They will see Tamal and they will embrace like Krishna. That, oh, direct, we are meeting with you. And then they will be happy. Or they will take something and they will
decorate themselves.
So I must be. Secondly, he is telling that it is true that anyone wants to be there where he is plenty of ananda. Huh? Happiness. He don't want to go to any place where there is less happiness and less love and affection. But this is not the nature of Krishna, Supreme Personality of Krishna, Godhead. His nature is some different. What? He has lakhs and lakhs devotees everywhere. Also, there are some devotees in Mathura, and they have been given so much sufferings by Kans, feeling so much. From when? Devaki and Vasudev are suffering from the very day when their marriage was going to hell. Krishna was there for about 10 years, 8 months in Braja. And from beginning of marriage, 8 sons were there with Krishna. So many years. And after that 10 years, 8 months more. How much years together?
About 19 years.
19 years? 7 years. Yes, it may be. Or this or so. It may be like 20 years, it may be. And they were being suffered by concern. So many persons left Mathura. They scattered here and there. And those who were there were always weeping and suffering. So how Krishna can give up them? He cannot neglect. He also, he should care. And if he is not taking care, then he is not merciful at all. Also Pandavas are weeping, Kunti is weeping for Krishna that he should come and help us. Draupadi calling him, oh, I am now becoming shameless. And she is calling bitterly. Oh, kissing his hands. Oh, Govinda, Raku Sarana, Avata Jivana Hari. Now I am dying. What Krishna will do? If he is playing in Ras Leela, in Vrindavan, in Bansivat, what he will do? He will have to save also. Any bhakta in any fire in this world, and he is calling Krishna. No, Krishna cannot remember. Otherwise, he will have to give up his name that you are Bhakta Vatsal. You are merciful. So he will have to take care of all. And that is why he was testing so much rush in Vrindavan. But also he will have to look after all the devotees. So there are so many devotees in Mathura, here and there. He should also hear their call. That is why Krishna also went there no harm. But something more. Because Krishna has promised, Je jathang mam prapadyante tam tathayo bhajamaham. Those who are serving me, I will have to repay them in the same way. But only there are gopi that he could not keep his promise. He failed to keep his promise. For all he can keep his promise, but for gopis nothing. So, it is sure that there is no comparison of whole world's any devotees like Brajavasi. Anyone cannot compare. Like Jashoda mother, like Sudal Subhan Subhan or others, like gopis, Lalita Vishakha and all others. Oh, there is no comparison. But Devaki and Vasudev, they have also did austerities, very hard austerity in their past. But you know, keeping their head down, standing on one ear and taking their feet high, without any air, water, in hot day, in winter season. Rainy season, always. How much? More than 60,000 years. Dhruva has done only, how much? Six months without air. And he, more than 60,000 years. And now he is calling in the form of Vasudeva and Devaki. Will he not hear? He must hear. This was also a reason to come to Mathura. Now, second thing, if Krishna finished his that cause, he came to save his father, mother, and he saved and he killed Kansa. So he came to kill Krishna, Kansa, and he finished this cause, then he must return to Vrindavan. But how he can? All the Jadvasi, Mathuravasi has escorted here and there for the fear of. So his whole kingdom was like Vishrinkal. Vishrinkal means? It was not in order. So Krishna gave the kingdom to Ugrasen Maharaj. He made him king. But he was so much old, powerless person. Krishna should manage. So he was managing. And if he not managing, that what will be? Oh, there were two wives of Kans, Asti and Prapti. They went to their father, Jarasandha. He was very big demon, like. Very powerful, more than Kansa and all others, Duryodhana and all. And when he heard that, oh, his son-in-law has been killed by Krishna, And he was innocent. Oh, already innocent. And this Krishna killed him. He was sitting on the throne only. And they jumped and took his. And without any reason. And they killed. He became so unhappy. Serious. And he took his soldiers, more than Mahabharata soldiers, army, so much army. 20 lakhs across of army he took, and he invaded at 18 times, not only time, 18 times. So Krishna knows that if I am going to Braja, then what happened? All will be killed by Jarasandha. So he cannot go. Can he go? If he goes to Vrindavan time to time, then what will become? Krishna wanted to go time to time. But if Jarasandha will know that really, oh, all the Brajvasi are so beloved, so dear to Krishna, so I will mash Vrindavan. There are no soldiers, no army. No killa, fort, nothing. And they are not warriors or wolves. Only grazing cows, very innocent. So in one day, Jarasandha will come and smash the whole Vrindavan. But Nanda Baba knows this. So Krishna told in his ear, don't be restless. I will come after finishing Jarasandha and all, and I will come. So I must come, but if I am now coming, time to time that comes will they will know, and they will attack whole Brijbhas, and then everything will be finished. I cannot save you. There is no fort, no army, nothing. So he is not coming. And more things. One thing, anyone goes to anywhere for any job or any duty. Vasudeva knows this very clearly, Vasudeva and Devaki, that Krishna has come from Vrindavan. And if Krishna returns to Vrindavan, he will never come. If anyone goes to anywhere, and Krishna tells that I am going to Indra Prastha, I am going to Mithila, or I am going here and there, they will know, never object. That you should go and very quickly you should return. But if Krishna wants any permission from Devaki and Vasudeva, that I want to go quickly to Vrindavan and I will return, then they become very, very, and they begin to weep, nothing telling anything, not giving
permission.
Why not? That Vrindavan is a Rasamayi Bhumi. He is not going to finish any. Any karma or any job or anything, and he will go and he will be totally absorbed in Rasa, because Vrindavan is Rasa Bhumi. Krishna is himself Rasa. All the gop and gopis are Rasa. So this is not a job, not a duty, not a anything. So he will not return. So when Krishna anyhow tells that may I go, they began to weep bitterly. Not only Devaki was there, whole Mathura Vasi began to weep that we will die today. What Krishna should do? That is why. Or sometimes he wants to go but cannot go. These are the reasons. Also, if he is going there, sometimes and only meeting with them and they, he can return, because Vrindavan is only two fingers far away from Vrindavan, Mathura. Only. And the place is what? Borderline. Only Mathura and Vrindavan, so nearer to nearer. He can go to Golok Vrindavan, he go, can go to Mithila, he can go to Dwarka in a moment. And why he cannot come in hour, 2 hours, he can come to Vrindavan. But he is not coming. Why? Because if he is going for a moment, then what becomes? The separation mode of gopis and gopis will go less and less time more. More and more. It will not subside, but it will increase so much. Why? If there is a lamp, the lamp of what? Lamp mein kya hota hai?
Flame.
If there is a flame in lamp, if there is a little air, it can be extinguished, it can be subsided. But if the fire is so in so big, big
jungle,
like forest.
Forest fire.
Can it be subsided by any air, or what it will be?
More increasing.
So, the suppression fire of gopis and gopis, Mathura is like this. It is not like a very pradeep that it will be subsided. Like, if you can put any
frying pan
on a stove, and it is like a radish, and give one
drop of water,
what it will be? And if it will touch your anywhere, you will be burned. So Vrindavan, fire, this separation mode is like this. If Krishna goes for a moment, for 1 day, 2 days, it will go so high that they will die at once. So he is not going with fear. Something also, if anyone questioning that Krishna should bring his father, mother, all the gopis, Sakha and all to Mathura, oh, there is very broad place. He can bring them. Why he is not bringing? Oh, there is something danger. What danger? Rasa Sankata. Rasa Sankata mane? There is Sankata of Rasa mane?
Danger
of exchanging of Rasa. What is that?
Contradiction of mellow.
Contradiction of mellow there. What? In Vrindavan, Krishna is like a cowherd boy, only son of Nanda Baba, without shoes and without umbrella, and serving all the cows, serving Nanda Baba Yashoda. And in Mathura, he is a Kshatriya king, very powerful. No flute, no stick, not cowherd boy, like a king. And what kind of king? Oh, he is samrat. What? Emperor. Emperor here. No one can challenge him there. But in Vrindavan, if he comes, or Brajavasi comes, then can he keep his peacock feather here? And his float on his ear, and like what he will tell? If Nanda Baba comes, then to whom he will tell, father and mother? To Devaki Vasudeva or Nanda Baba? And to whom in night he will be? Will gopis or Satyabhama Rukmini? there will be fight.